Hi, my name is Dmitry, and I'm the developer of InfraNodus Text Network Analysis and Visualization app. I'm going to show you in this video how you can use InfraNodus to visualize all your Rome research notes to see how they're connected, to have a good overview of the main topics inside, and also to be able to zoom in and see what are the main concepts, how they're related, and what are the gaps so you can generate new ideas. So first of all, you will need to log in into InfraNodus, and by the way, the final result will look something like this. You will see all your notes, you will be able to see the relations between them as a graph, and also zoom into your ideas to see which context you use these notions that you're interested in. So first of all, open the applications page, and then choose the Rome Research import app. And here, now it's a new feature, you can actually choose several files. So in this case, I will use Robert Haysfield notes again, just like last time. I select them all, open the files. You see it's 462 notes that he has. And here you can choose what you would like to visualize. So I'm just going to zoom in that you can see it better. Mainly at the beginning, you could just analyze only the content of all the notes, and this is why this option is default. But I want to show you how you can also see the connections between the notes. So choose the content and the connections between the notes, and then make sure that this option is also checked. Include the selected files as the nodes in the graph. Like this, you will be able to see all the notes and their connections. Then you click save. What happens is that now InfraNodus imports all these 462 files. And what it does is that it visualizes every word that you use as a node in the graph and every co-occurrence of those words as the connections. And then it builds a graph which shows you how those words are related, what communities they form, what are the most influential terms, and how they connect to one another. On top of that, it will also import the names of your actual files and all the wiki links, all the square bracket links that you have inside your files. So you can see also how all those files are connected. You probably know in Rome Research, you already have this option to see the graph, but it doesn't really give you the graph analysis insights into your notes. And InfraNodus does that. It can show you not only how all those different notes are connected, but also what are the most important ones, what are the most influential ones, and so on. So as you can see, it takes a little bit of time to import this data because there's quite a lot of processing involved. But once you wait, it will be worth it because here you have a nice visualization. I'm going to click on seeing all the statements. You have a nice visualization here of all the notes that Rob has. So first of all, I'm going to show you some things you can do to the graph to make it more readable. Let me zoom in so you can see it better. You have this option here that in the settings in the right menu that allows you to filter the notes. So I would remove the less relevant ones like this, and you can do it gradually. Like this, you can see what are the most important notes that he has. So in this case, for instance, it's the note on gamification. It's quite important in his body of notes, and the notes on Rome, and also the note on what's happening, gamification and playfulness in Headspace. Headspace is an app for meditation. And also he has this note, Metroidvania, I guess it's another app, Paler State, and so on. So you have a very good overview now of all these 462 notes. It would take you ages to read through them, but now you have a very nice overview of what he's writing about, what are the main ideas inside, and so on. And if you click on the notes, for example, gamification, you will see all the notes that link to that note. That's called gamification. So all the notes that have this wiki link or square brackets inside, right? So this allows us to see all the connections between different nodes. If you're not afraid of the graph, you can show all of the notes and all the terms inside. Okay, so another thing that you can do is to actually filter the graph. So for example, let's say that you don't want to see the actual notes, but you only want to see the words that he's using. So we want to understand what he's writing about. In this case, we go once again to this filter app and then click filter graphs, all except mentions. Mentions are the notes. So we click all except mentions, and then we see the actual language that he uses in his notes. Okay, can get rid of this, by the way. Okay, so then we see all the language that he uses, and then in the analytics panel, we will be able to see the main topics and how they connect. And if you click on some of them, so for example, game, user, app, let's say, you can see in which nodes he's using these exact terms. So it becomes like ROM research graphs, but on steroids, where you can see all the different words, all the different concepts, all the main connections. And what's also nice to do, and this is a great feature that you can try, is if you see some stuff that are obvious, so for example, you understand that he's writing about user experience and games and people, right? So you want to see what's hiding behind those terms. You can select them. So for example, app. Let's also select this, yeah. And then you click here on the trash button and you remove those nodes from the graph so you can see what other terms are hiding behind them. And by the way, if you want to analyze the actual terms, so not the connections between the nodes, but what content he's using, you can go back into the ROM import app and just choose all the same files and use the default import option. Okay, so you don't actually, now I'm selecting all the files, all the 462 files. And here I leave the default option, only show the content of the notes, exclude the links, all right? So I will call it Rob's Notes, no links, okay? Then click Save. And what happens now is that we import all this data, but now we don't import the wiki links, we only import the actual content of the notes. So we can see what he's writing about. Once we had an overview of all the notes and how they're connected, so gamification, you know, Rome and so on, now we can see what he's actually writing about, what are the main concepts inside, what he's interested in, how does he relay them together. And we will be able to see this on the graph. Now it's loading and I'm gonna zoom in and you will see that, okay, he's writing about users, app behavior, and then how people make time and so on. If you don't like to analyze graph and you want something a bit more specific, let's say where the analysis is done for you, you can click on this analytics panel here and you will see the four main topical groups. And this gives you an idea of what they're about. So for example, here it's user app goal. So it's the goals that users have inside the apps. If you click on that, you will see the statements where these terms appear. You can also click on those terms and get to the actual notes, actual blocks in the notes that contain the highest concentration of those terms. So this can be super useful as well. And then there is also something about people make time. Okay, so the notion of time and how important it is in the app. And then we have something about point, learn, understanding. Okay, and then how gamification works inside the games. You can also click here and see all the topics that exist inside. And here are the most influential elements. The most influential elements are not the most frequent words. It's the words that appear most often between different topics in his notes. Okay, so it's the topics, it's the notions with the highest influence inside this discourse. User, game, app, goal, make. Okay, then one feature that I want to show you that's super interesting is the Insight tab. If you click on the Insight in Analytics, you will see that there is an action advice, develop periphery. And it's based on the analysis of the network structure of this discourse. What InfraNodus does is that it detects the two different topics that exist in this discourse that could be connected but are not yet very well connected. So they are related, but they could be related much better. And what's used here as the rationale, I'm going to actually explain where it comes from, is that in social sciences you have this idea of structural holes. Imagine you have a group of people and there are different subgroups inside. So in social sciences, there is this idea that if you connect two different groups that are related but not yet connected, you will generate some new, interesting, innovative ideas and interactions. So if you're a social broker that connects two different groups, let's say someone who works, I don't know, on the new digital technology and on the new ways to derive energy, maybe not so related, but somehow you connect them together, there might be some new interesting ideas. So we transfer this metaphor into text networks and we look at the graph of the text that you can see on your screen right now, and we look into the two topics that could be connected but are not yet. And then InfraNodus proposes you to make a connection between them so that you can bridge the gap between these two clusters of ideas. In our case, it's gamification, okay, and also something about points and learning and understanding. So another topic. And if we click on these two, we will see, okay, gamification, set, gamification, game. Okay, so then we can see which nodes relate to these three words, have a better understanding of the context, and then click on those, see where they appear, what context it is, and then we will be able to understand what question we should ask that would connect those two ideas together. By the way, you can also do the same if you click on statements to link. It's going to show you the two statements that you can link together, or the two sub-blocks in notes. And if it was you who was making the notes, actually, it would be much easier to you to find a way to think between those two different topics and to generate a new idea. So try it out with all these features, especially with the insight feature on your own notes or on somebody else's public notes. You can use it for Rome research, Obsidian, Rem notes, and basically wherever you can export your notes as MD files. So you can just export them all at once, visualize them as a graph, find the connections between the notes, and then use the specific granular text network analysis to see what are the main concepts inside and how they're connected. You can try it on infranodus.com, and I'll put a link in the description to this video that explains the process step by step. And if you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be happy to answer. This feature is still in development, so if you have some requests, if you think something could work better, please let me know as well. And in the next video, I'm going to talk about using InfraNodus for analyzing scientific papers, and I think it can be also interesting. Thank you very much, and thank you for using InfraNodus.